We're now going to get into the study of finite wing theory. Hopefully you are familiar with airfoil theory at this point and feel comfortable with that. Now in airfoil theory, what we've done is we've actually treated the wing as an infinite wing or a wing of infinite span. So what we've looked at is the vorticity, for example, from either the vortex panel method or from thin airfoil theory. We have vorticity that we've placed along this airfoil, and those were actually we looked at this in just a two-dimensional plane, which means that those were line vortices going in and out of the page here, and we assumed that they were of infinite length. And so there was no aerodynamic properties that changed in the span-wise direction. Okay, that they were constant in the span-wise direction. So that allowed us to look at the airfoil as in a two-dimensional plane. Well, as you know, wings are not infinite. And so if we look at some wing here of finite span, now, of course, the cross section looks like an airfoil, but we've got to understand some physical properties of this wing and how the flow reacts to that. So a few things to note is that the lift distribution actually goes to zero at the root and the tip. So if we were to draw kind of some curve that represents the amount of lift or the pressure distribution or really the difference between the pressure on the top of the wing and the bottom, I would look something like that, where it goes to zero at the two tips. Also, in the chordwise direction, we would see that the pressure looks something like this, which you should be familiar with from airfoil theory, but that's how the lift would kind of be distributed on chordwise and spanwise along this wing. So it turns out that the properties change in the spanwise direction, and the reason the lift goes to zero at the tip is because of course we have a high pressure on the bottom. So I'm going to put a plus down here. We've got high pressure on the bottom, and we've got low pressure on the top. And at the wingtip, it actually cannot support a pressure difference. And so we're gonna get some, what some people might call spillage of that airflow around the edge of the wing here, going from the high pressure to the low pressure. And actually the wingtip, there cannot be any pressure difference between the upper and lower surfaces. Because there's nothing there to create that pressure difference. There's no way to keep the pressure high below and low above. So we end up with a zero pressure difference, and therefore, because of that, the lift goes to zero at the wingtip. So let's look at the front of a wing. If we were to look at this straight on, and we have low pressure on the bottom and high pressure on the top. So then we get some flow that's going to come around the edge of that wing there. And if we were to look at this wing from the top down and say that the velocity was coming in from this direction here, what happens is the velocity near the center line, let's just look at the velocity on the top surface of the wing. On the top, the velocity along the center line is going to be pretty straight, but as we move out towards the wing tip, remember we have some flow coming from the bottom of the wing up towards the top. It's spilling over the top. So what happens is it's going to actually push the flow inboard along the top of the wing, something like this. And then if we looked at the bottom of the wing, we'd find that the flow is moving slightly outboard because that flow, again, spilling around the edge of the tip. moving from the lower surface to the upper surface. So what happens is when that flow gets to the trailing edge of the wing here, we have flow from the bottom that is moving outward, and we have flow from the top that's moving inward, and so that produces this difference in the direction of that flow and creates what we call vorticity. Vorticity in the flow, okay? It actually creates a vortex sheet, a continuous sheet of vorticity back here from the trailing edge aft, and we'll have a bunch of vorticity here in the, or a sheet of vorticity here that's continuous, all right? So, okay, so now, if we were to follow these streamlines downstream, we would see that actually they don't remain straight like this. In fact, they actually start to coalesce, and that's because we're gonna, what happens here with this trailing vorticity is so we've got some velocity moving in this direction here, and as these other this vorticity comes off here, or these streamlines, they're going to actually end up rolling up around and coalescing into a very large vortex structure here far behind the wing. And in a potential flow simulation or analysis, these vortices, the vorticity here that shed from this wing, would extend infinitely. It would never dissipate, but actually, due to viscosity in the air, these vortices eventually dissipate. But it actually takes quite a while downstream of the swing before that vorticity dies out. And so that's one reason that you don't want to fly an aircraft too closely behind another aircraft, and why formation flying is so tricky. The position of those two airplanes has to be very precisely controlled so that one does not enter this this trailing vortex sheet that is being caused by the main wing of another aircraft. So these are just some basic fundamental principles to understand about finite wings. The first theory that was developed that really produced good solid results for finite wings, for predicting the aerodynamics of finite wings, was developed by Prandtl, by Ludwig Prandtl, and it's called the classical lifting line theory. We're going to spend quite a bit of time on that theory because there's a lot to learn from that theory. Now it is a potential flow theory, so it neglects viscosity in the flow, but it actually ends up being very or really quite accurate for most applications, and it's rather simple to solve for some complex applications. So we're going to spend quite a bit of time in that theory, and then we'll also look at some numerical methods for computing the aerodynamics of finite wings as well.